Hello, welcome to Jackrabbit Journal. The South Coast State football team beats Indiana State 24-7 and threw in a little surprise before the game. Before we get to the quarterback questions that are surrounding this game, Hank, a good bounce back after the Jackrabbit loss to NDSU, wasn't it?
It was a great bounce back win. It was exactly what the program needed. The guys stepped up on both sides of the ball, made some plays here and there. Defensively, they were most impressive, in my opinion. Yeah. Indiana State coming in, they were scoring points and putting up some big numbers in the stat columns. The guys really responded exactly how everybody in Jackrabbit Nation would hope they would. Heck of a win for the guys.
All right, before the game, the Jacks quietly made the announcement that Taryn Christian would be the starter at quarterback. The red shirt comes off, and the young man from Sioux Falls plays in his first college football game and played very well by all accounts.
He sure did. It's not every day that you see a young guy like that come in and contribute the way that he did, with the poise that he did and the confidence that he did. Sure, you see freshman players come in and contribute in certain roles, but this is the quarterback position. Yeah. And make no mistake of it, folks, it takes a special individual to step into that role and not just do your job and facilitate the game, manage the game, but make plays and really be a leader.
Had a big impact. You really did. 221 yards passing, and Christian, the leading rusher for the Jackrabbits as well, with 99 yards on 16 carries. And again, maybe overlooked in this game, but not by you, the SDSU defense. The Sycamores were averaging 38 per game, and South Coast State holds them to just 7.
Huge bounce-back performance by that unit. And they had really carried over from the NDSU game, because those guys didn't play bad in the second half of the Bison game. So it was good to see them string a solid 6 quarters of very high-quality football together, something that group will be able to build on moving through the Missouri Valley Conference.
All right, who plays quarterback this week at Youngstown State? We will dig into that a little bit later. But next, Coach Stig talking about the decision to go with Taryn Christian and the big plays of the first half against Indiana State.
Jackrabbit Journal on Midco Sports Network is presented by Dakota Land Honda.
Let's get to the first half against Indiana State. And before that, here's Coach Stiegelmeier talking about the decision to start Taryn Christian at quarterback.
When you get to the fifth game of the season and you're thinking about pulling a red shirt, meaning a guy's already missed 4 games, you look at not the individual as much as you look at the team, because that's what has to rule the decision. And then it became crystal clear what we needed to do.
All right. Yeah. I mean, was it an agonizing choice, or was it, you know, you got Dalton Douglas sitting there? Kind of go through what went into the decision to pull the red shirt and play Taryn Christian in this game.
Well, there's a lot of vectors here that are intersecting. Right. Number one, will Lujan be ready? You know, so we're practicing all week with the chance that he might be ready. Then who is number two? And can Zach play? If Zach can play, is it Dalton? Do you not pull the red shirt? So all those things, and you'd like to think we could flip a coin and it's that easy, but it's not.
All right, so it comes down to number one, gets the start here in his first collegiate game, Taryn Christian, kid from Sioux Falls Roosevelt High School, and using his feet here on the first play of the game.
Yeah, he was ready. I mean, he was ready game plan-wise. He's ready confidence-wise, leader-wise, and obviously he's a gifted student athlete. So, you know, there he made something happen. He had success by running the ball on a scramble. You'd prefer he threw the ball. Here he does a nice job early getting it to Jake. That was a poised play and a good guy to throw the ball to.
Yeah, nice to have Jake Winicky there to help you out in your first game. You get down to the goal line here on the first drive, and it looks like Taryn gets in here, but they say he didn't.
Well, it's a good call on our part. You know, I think he's in. Again, if we have a replay, that's a touchdown. You know, if we are not building a new stadium and we have the replay, which we could have, and that's what the official said. I mentioned to him, well, that's why you get paid the big bucks. But it looks like he's in. But again, I'm glad I'm a coach and not an official. And I think sometimes you think, okay, we're going to get it in. It's on the 6-yard line, and here's the result. You know, we don't get it in. Brady could have made a better cut, a different cut, give them some credit. But that's the fickleness of this whole game. That play could have literally cost us a game, potentially.
Right, yes. Defense comes back, though. This is a great play by Drew Kreitzfeld.
Yeah, Drew is playing at a really high level. He's a senior. He's earned a starting spot. for the first time, solidified that, and he keeps getting better. So it's really cool to see that happen.
And another guy that's earned some time, Kyle Paris at running back.
Yeah, Kyle, he's been doing such a great job in practice and on special teams, and Coach McKissick Luke said, hey, it's your turn, and really had the best game as a running back for us. He's a whole different runner than the other two guys we've played, and it's fun to see him have success.
All right, so Christian hooking up here on a first down to Dallas Goddard.
Yeah, just a simple three guys run out, get to the first down marker, throw it. They had a guy that got seriously injured on that play. Kind of was a bummer in the game. I found out he was healthy at the end. But here again, throwing to that's a play we ran a bunch last year against them. We didn't run it as much this year. They defended it a little differently. But again, that's a pretty easy target when you have Jake in a long body running a slant.
Pretty good throw, though, by Christian, and then he scores his first touchdown here.
Yeah, he should wait for the blocker on the draw. He's a little anxious there. The back was supposed to lead him up, and the back was following him. But again, his athletic ability, defense to Indiana State, they didn't know he was going to play. They don't know anything about Taryn Christian, so they might have had a little different game plan based on his ability.
All right, Jacks lead 7-0, and then your defensive line had some fun in this game.
Well, I am so proud of our defensive line because that quarterback is a special player, and we contained him, and then we retraced our steps. I think we got 3 sacks just by containing him and retracing the steps, so really proud of how they played.
And then Shane Gottlob putting on some pressure here. Cole Langer is going to run him down on the sideline.
Yeah, you know, we talked to those guys about having grabbing cloth, grabbing flesh, hanging on. That's easier said than done, but great effort always wins, and Cole gets over there and gets the sack.
And Chase Kern, I should say, they're putting some pressure on, but after an Indiana State punt, Christian again.
Again, we suffer from this too when we defend a running quarterback. That is so hard to defend. You literally have to put in a different defense sometimes when that quarterback is a running back type. This is really a nice play. You know, a good play action, isolate Jake. And again, it's still got to be a perfect throw because that's pretty good coverage. Really happy for that combo to get that touchdown.
All right, 14-0. Jack's in the lead. And then we get late in the first half here. And talk about throwing on the run. This was pretty nice and a great catch by Cam Jones.
Well, this is, again, buying time, being poised, true freshman. Great play by Cam, keeping a foot in. We had managed the clock pretty well there. We got him into a punt situation, used our timeouts. So we needed a play like that to get down here to the goal line.
And then second and goal. There's no timeouts left. What happens here at the end of the first half?
Boy, I'd like to say no comment.
But, all right, well done.
A lot of fans had some comments for me as we walked off. We simply put too much on Terrence plate in that play, and it was a run-pass situation, and the common sense says you're never going to run the ball down there. Well, all those things, that's our fault. That's my fault, and shouldn't have put him in that situation.
But he's riding it through to Brady and supposedly going to pull it out of there and then throw the football.
Throw that's the slant what it should to Jake Winicky. Same thing we scored against North Dakota State to go ahead. Same thing Jake caught earlier in the game. But again, all those things going on, you're not thinking about 12 seconds sometimes. I was, but yeah. He wasn't.
All right. Physically, Taryn Christian looks like he is ready to step in and play. Mentally, how was he in this game, making decisions?
I thought he made the right checks. The only thing I think we'd like him to do is just slow the game down a little bit. He went back to pass sometimes and didn't go through his progression and was real quick. But again, a guy with his ability, you can run and get some yards and have success doing it.
All right. You don't get in on that first drive. You don't get in on the last drive. Could have, should have, would have been 28-0 at halftime, shouldn't it?
Well, it could have, should have. You know, I think those types of games give you this feeling as a football program, we're going to win this. But I tell you what, you have no control over the other team, and you need to take advantage of those opportunities, get in the end zone, and secure the win, really.
So that was not necessarily a run call. It was a run pass option for Taryn Christian. He made the mistake of handing the ball off, and they don't get into the end zone. But did Taryn Christian live up to the build-up and the expectations?
Oh, I think he certainly did. He exceeded my expectations for his performance. With any rookie, especially at the quarterback position, you never know what you've got until you roll him out there. He was fantastic.
All right, second half coming up with Coach Stiegelmeier when we return on Jack Journal.
Jackrabbit Journal on Midco Sports Network is presented by Dakota Land Honda.
There was a little more chaos than usual surrounding this game for the Jackrabbits, new quarterback. There were a lot of injuries, officials taking a lot of time to sort things out. With all that going on, Stig says that Taryn Christian and all of his guys really made a few mistakes but made a lot of good decisions and a lot of good plays in this game.
We took a team that was high-powered on offense and shut him down, essentially. We coulda, shoulda, without some missed field goals and just marching the ball, we coulda scored umpteen touchdowns. So there's a lot of positives, but human beings are on the field, and human beings make mistakes, and I make mistakes, and so a lot more positives than negatives.
All right, and defensively, as you said, took a team that was averaging 38 a game, pretty much shut them down, and Nick Farina right away here in the second half with an interception.
Yeah, big play, easy play, really, but he was where he's supposed to be, read the quarterback, and we have to turn that into offense. You know, we need to, as a defense, we need to block, and that's the easiest offensive play. This is disappointing. I go out with the kickers. Jake Carlson normally in that range is 12 for 12 all day long, and he suffered. He struggled during this game.
Yeah, it would have been good from about 60, but he missed it. This broken play here, Cole Langer, questionable. Something maybe should have been thrown there, but they end up with a touchdown.
He gets whacked. Everybody should be in front of us. And that guy came at Jerrion. Jerrion should have stayed with him. We should have had a secondary linebacker come out of coverage and make him throw the ball. And consequently, they get an easy one.
All right. And as you said, their quarterback can run and can throw it a little bit, too. It's 14-7, Jacks. And then go to the fourth quarter here. Carlson does hit from 21 yards. It's 17-7. I don't know how you guys keep doing this, but you did it again.
Well, we practice it, number one. And Coach Rogers does a great job. You can see him directing traffic there in the yellow hat. It's part of the strategy of football. Lob it. Ideally, you don't get a return. We were kicking into a decent wind, so we thought that was the ideal thing. And it's just a big play. Dallas Brown was heads up on that.
Kyle Paris chugging ahead here for 8 more yards, and then he's going to get a touchdown here on the direct snap for his first collegiate touchdown.
I love the way he runs the ball. His pads are in front of his toes, and he, you can see it here. He's going to get in the end zone, and credit the O-line there. Look where the defensive line ended up pushing him back in the end zone. So I think we got a little different feeling when we got close to the goal line there than we did in the first half.
24-7, Jacks in the lead, and then more defense coming up here. Nick Mears and Kellen Solik on a sack, and then another one coming up for J.R. Plody.
Yeah, we didn't blitz much in the game. In fact, it was late in the game. Coach Brown was feeling confident. He said, let's blitz him, and I said, do not blitz him. So he said, I thought you could have fun today, and I said, winning's fun. So great play again by J.R. And our defense, like we said, our defense played really well.
They had one of the bigger offensive lines I've ever seen. The guys were huge, and your guys would just kind of run them one way and come back the other way, didn't they?
Well, we knew we weren't going to bull rush them, so we tried to contain them, get them setting deep, and then try to retrace. If you try to go underneath them, you can win sometimes, but then that quarterback gets out, and you have the same scramble problems we had on their touchdown.
All right, million-dollar question. What do you do at quarterback this week? I know it's very early in the week here, but what's the thought process on who's going to play quarterback? Can you play with two? What's going to happen?
Well, we can do whatever we want. We're going to do what's best for the football team. Our program, if you lose, if you don't start because of an injury, you're still the starter. So we're going to evaluate Zach Lujan, and I know he's working his tail off to get healthy, and by the end of the week we'll know. But right now we're in a good situation.
Defensively, just talk about, again, Indiana State comes in with that high power, with all the numbers anyway, but did you do anything different defensively in this game than you have in the first four?
We played one different coverage, a three-deep coverage that it looked like two deep at the snap of the ball. I think that confused them a little bit, but I really think it was our guys doing what they were taught during the week. They talked about the defensive ends, talked about the corners, you know, keep the stuff in front of you. They did it over and over and over. When you do that, the team's got to beat you. You don't beat yourself.
And we talked about this last week. Do the things in the game that you do in practice all week, and it seems like you did on this one.
Right. We call it mastery, all right? I mean, you master a defense, and then literally they have to be better than you to beat you. And I'm not saying we're better than Indiana State, but if you master your stuff, they have to out-execute you on the football field.
Well, up next,
holy nutmeg!
Holy nutmeg! We have the sounds of Stiegelmeier. We'll tag along with the coach before and during the game.
Jackrabbit Journal on Midco Sports Network is presented by Dakota Land Honda.
Welcome back. Our producer David Brown had a microphone on Coach Stiegelmeier before, during, and after this game against Indiana State. It's a really good piece. If you want to know what Stig has to say about stuff on the sidelines and in the locker room, here you go.
16's our starting quarterback. He's not going to start. Okay? He's injured. So we're going to have a true...
Not playing.
Well, he may play, but it's doubtful. We'd be dire straits if we. So the guy that's going to start is a true freshman. You're going to mentor him through his first reps. Taryn.
Taryn. I'm Darren. He's Taryn.
Okay.
Super.
Is this where your locker?
This is great.
Oh, you're in the cop deal?
We're in a police officer. Yeah. They got us in the locker rooms of the police officers. We feel pretty safe in there.
Yeah.
It's great.
Yeah, I'm not excited about him being here because I drive my moped on the sidewalks once in a while. So, take care, you guys. Yeah. By the way, I was trying to get where kick field goes from. So, if you wanted that high level information,
no, that's okay.
As if it ever goes the way you plan it, right? Did you have a weekend off or what?
Birthday party tomorrow for Sarah.
Oh, we're just a filler.
No.
Good for you. Good for you. We need it, right? I know you'll make noise.
It's good to see you again. It's been a while. I think you owe me a malt.
I got a lot of malt over.
So I think you owe me from when we were at Northern Iowa.
Are you sure you will?
I think so. I won that. Yes, sir.
Put your address down. I've paid off.
No,
I lost one last week, too.
No.
So, in fact, he didn't even flinch last week. He said, you're losing this one.
Well, it's good to see you.
Good to see you.
Good
Let's have fun
you.
Today.
Yes,
all right.
Sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Make plays. Let's go. Let's just do our deal, okay? Let's be great coaches because you are great coaches. Let's go. Let's go. Good luck. Let's go. Good luck. Let's go. Be great. Be great. Hey, how about we define as a football program what it means to play your last play? How about today we put a stamp on that statement, all right? You got it? Don't say it. Go do it, right? Let's go show the world, all right? Let's get it done. Let's go. Good luck. Good luck, Mike.
You too.
Yeah! The face mask. Grab his face mask!
Here we go, let's
go to 12. Hey! He grabbed his face mask! Darren, that's a penalty! That's a penalty! Look at the film! Call the penalties, come on, holy nutmeg. Time out, time out, time out, time out or not? Time out, time out, time out!
Third and goal for Taryn Christian. Option look again, Mangarelli was the pitch man there. Christian's gonna get right to the goal line, and he is stopped just short. Langer and Lusher leading it to that left side, and Mangarelli got stacked up and did not get in.
Yay, hey! You got two bad calls already. He was in the end zone. Come on, come on. Hey, we don't dog jet, right?
What?
Did you guys dog jet?
Yeah, that's okay. Yeah,
we don't do that. Hey, Kirk, jet is jet, right? Jet is jet. Oh, we blocked him and he made the tackle. Who pulled the guard? Who's a good guard? Are you telling our team to go out on the timeout? Is that your job? Who tells our team to go out on the timeout stuff?
It just depends.
We don't want to go out and stand there and show our formation.
Yeah.
When this guy stands out here for 30 seconds.
Understandable.
So we want when he leaves, we want to go. Okay.
We'll make sure we'll tell
Will you.
That.
Tell
yes,
him. Thank
yes,
you.
Sir, thank
Thanks.
You.
Good job, Kyle. Dallas.
Winicky all by himself out there to the right side. Christian. On a little delay, is going to get to the end line and a touchdown, South Dakota State.
Calm him down, huh? Calm him down. They can't break the huddle of 12 guys. They had a guy run off. Come on. Holy nutmeg.
They get their 3 seconds to move off. They have to be able to run off the field, and they did. He ran off the field. They'd have 12.
I don't think so.
If he came on, the other guy went right
off. I don't think so. I think they ran.
I did my count
twice. No, they ran a guy here, and then they ran another guy off.
I had 11 the whole time.
I bet you malt.
Well, I don't want to bet a malt.
I got malts bet all over the Missouri Valley. Let's go. I owe that guy over there.
I had 11 twice. I promise.
Okay. All right. I believe you. Then I owe you malt.
Okay.
All right? Okay. I like chocolate chip, though.
Okay.
Come on, man. Tackle. Wrap up and tackle. Wrap up and tackle. All right? Get in their legs and tackle them. Let's go.
The down's over. It's going to be fourth down. It's after the play.
So, yeah, fourth down after back here. Thank you so much. All right, thanks. Ball is live. Get ready, man. Get ready. Hey! 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 What are you doing? Then don't even look at him. Just walk up. You said it with your pads, right?
Time out.
Make sure you tell Taryn what it looks like, JD, about killing the clock, right, Spike? He has made some great plays. He's a great player, but there's some other plays he can make, right? He'll be better.
Thanks so much, Coach.
I'm not going to talk, all right? Seniors, what do you got? Captains, what do you got?
Boys, go to work. That was a good half, but it could be so much better. Everyone in this room knows that. We played that well, not playing that great of a half. Think about what we can do if we play up to our potential.
Is that enough said?
Yeah.
Let's go, last play. Let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Last play.
That is part one with Coach Steg, and we'll finish it up next week here on Jack Journal. Up next, at Youngstown State this Saturday, what have the Penguins got, and who's going to play quarterback for South Dakota State?
Jackrabbit Journal on Midco Sports Network is presented by Dakota Land Honda.
Well, Jackrabbits play at Youngstown State on Saturday, 3 o'clock Central Time start. The Penguins are 1-1 in the Missouri Valley, beat South Dakota, and then lost to Illinois State at home this past Saturday. They've got a really good run game, good quarterback. SDSU has won the last three, though, at Youngstown State. So, for the Jackrabbits, who's going to start at quarterback this week?
I think that's an easy question this week. If Zach's ready to go, he'll probably be the guy. If he's not, then Taryn's going to get his second shot in the blue and yellow. But everybody knows in Stig's program, can't lose your job to injury.
All right. Will be interesting, and we'll talk about it next week. For Hank McCall, I'm Tom Nieman.